Okay, that brings us to the first big question we're asking on the Weekend Edition today. Is it fair to use the term Hindu terror now in the light of the Malegaon investigation? Joining us on the show, Chandan Mitra, Member of Parliament, Editor-in-Chief of the Pioneer, close to the BJP, Manish Tiwari, Congress spokesperson. Also with us, Lieutenant General Patankar. Thanks very much, General Patankar, for joining us, giving us three different perspectives. First to you straight, Dr. Chandan Mitra. We use the term Islamic terror. Can we now use safely the term Hindu terror too?
Certainly not. To begin with, the terror charge against whoever has not as yet been proved at all. There are a whole series of accusations and allegations, not a shred of evidence so far. And I think this entire thing has been done with a certain political purpose. But without going into that, one can certainly say that to call it Hindu terror is, I think, a deliberate ploy to try and equate what has been going on in this country and in the rest of the world, right, and is rightly described as jihadi terror.
So
if there were genuine Hindu terror in this country, I'm afraid there would be a bloodbath, the kind we have never seen before.
Okay. That's your perspective. Let's get in Manish Tiwari. Manish Tiwari, the Congress is interesting. A section of the Congress seems to be blaming the entire Sangh Parivar for these after these arrests. Another section is very quiet, perhaps fearing a Hindu polarization in elections. Where does the Congress stand on the Malegaon probe?
Well, the Congress is very clear. The Congress does not believe that there was any Muslim terror or there is any Hindu terror in the country. Because terror has no religion, it has no creed. Terror is terror, and terrorist is a terrorist. Having said that, it's very unfortunate that a party which had been going hammer and tongs on the whole question of terror over the last 4 years, you know, now is trying to make this distinction between one kind of terror and the other. I think this is most reprehensible. In fact, the Bharatiya Janata Party is a responsible political party, should have come out up front and said that if any of the people who were affiliated with us or any of the people who have been our members are found to be involved, let the law take its own course. Why are they going on a limb defending them?
Respond to that, Chandan Mitra. The BJP party president Rajnath Singh comes out openly in defense of the Sadhvi. Praveen Thogadi of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad goes a step further and says a Hindu can never be a terrorist. The Congress is saying, why not allow the law to take its own course? That's what Manish Tiwari is saying.
We'd happily do that. In fact, I think every senior BJP leader has repeatedly said that the law must take its course. And if you find anybody guilty, I mean, punish him or her.
Sir, that's not what Rajnath Singh is saying.
Of course,
that's
before what, you do that,
Mr. L.K. Advani, may have said that. And to an extent, other leaders like Arun Jaitley are silent, but Rajnath Singh is openly coming out in defense of the Sadhvi, even while the investigation is on.
Rajnath Singh, the spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party, said that it's a sponsored investigation. The International General Secretary of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad says that the ATS is fabricating evidence. This is the same ATS they were patting on the back a couple of months ago when they were cracking other bomb blast cases. So why these double standards?
Yes, respond, Chandan.
Just a minute. Rajdeep, I would like to counter that. Yes. If the government had shown one-tenth of the kind of alacrity and determination as they have shown in this particular case when it came to cracking other jihadi terrorist cases, I think nobody would have accused the government of
political motivation. Ask Dr. Chandan Mitra as to who cracked the Delhi blast and who cracked the Ahmedabad blast? It was nobody else except this UPA government which did that. To say that we move on one kind of terror and do not move on another kind of terror, I think is a complete misstatement because from the perspective of the UPA and the government, we don't make a distinction.
Yes, Chandan, respond to the fact that there are double standards involved here.
Rajdeep,
yes.
I would just ask one very short question to Manish Tiwari.
Yes.
That then, in that event, if you want all the credit, why don't you want to execute the Supreme Court order awarding the death sentence to Afzal Guru? He has been found guilty. Why don't you proceed?
No.
Just do that and then we'll accept your
Respond to that.
Yes, respond to that.
Rajdeep, may I respond to that?
Yes, go on.